In this video, we are going to show you how to set up and align your Infinity Telescope. Your telescope is an excellent beginner's instrument and is designed to observe objects in the sky and also on land. Here are a few of the features that set the Meade Infinity Telescope system apart from all others. First, let's go over what accessories are included with the Infinity and what apertures are available. The Infinity series refracting telescopes come in 6 different sizes. The 50mm comes with two 1.25-inch Huygens eyepieces and one symmetric Ramsden eyepiece, a 1.5x erecting eyepiece, diagonal mirror, 5x24 viewfinder, and a 0.965-inch to 1.25-inch adapter. The 60 and 70mm come with two 1.25-inch MA eyepieces, 90-degree erect image diagonal mirror, 2x Barlow, red dot viewfinder, and yoke-style mount. The 80, 90, and 102mm come with 3 MA eyepieces, 90-degree erect image diagonal prism, 2x Barlow, red dot viewfinder, and alt-azimuth mount with slow motion controls. You'll want to set the telescope up in a large open area where you can see lots of sky. Make sure the ground is stable and is approximately level. To set up the tripod, spread the legs out evenly and place it on a solid surface. Set the height of your tripod to your desired height. Then, attach the accessory tray by placing the hole in the center of the accessory tray over the attachment point. Then rotate the tray until the wings of the tray snap into place on the tripod leg brace supports. For the 50mm, attach the accessory tray. Then, attach the optical tube to the mount by placing the optical tube mounting plate over the top of the mount until the mounting holes line up. Place the optical tube to mount lock knob through the mounting holes and tighten until snug. Attach the viewfinder and viewfinder bracket. Insert the diagonal mirror into the eyepiece holder and an eyepiece into the diagonal mirror. For the 60 and 70mm, attach the accessory tray. Continuing, attach the optical tube to the mount. Remove the two lock knobs, slide the altitude rod into the altitude lock knob, and place the optical tube between the forks of the mount. Thread the lock knobs through each of the holes in the forks of the mount and tighten. For the 80, 90, and 102mm, attach the accessory tray. Then, attach the slow motion controls by attaching the flexible cables to the mount. The cables are secured in place with a firm tightening of the thumb screws located at the attachment ends of each cable. To attach the OTA, locate the threaded hole in the bottom side of the dovetail mounting rail and place the dovetail onto the top of the mount, lining up the threaded hole near the center of the dovetail rail. Turn the optical tube attachment knob counterclockwise until firm. Attach the viewfinder, and attach the diagonal prism and eyepiece. Now, align the viewfinder. During the daytime, you'll want to point the telescope at an easy-to-find land object, such as the top of a telephone pole, or a distant mountain or tower. For the 50mm, images are either backwards or upside down, depending on the rotation angle of the diagonal mirror. This is completely normal. Looking through the eyepiece, point the OTA at some well-defined distant land object. Look through the viewfinder and tighten or loosen the viewfinder's bracket's 3 collimation screws until the crosshairs of the viewfinder are precisely centered. When finished, tighten the viewfinder's 3 collimation screws to a firm feel so that it remains in alignment. For all other models, point the telescope at an easy-to-find land object. Look through the eyepiece and turn the focuser knob until the image is sharply focused. Now, your telescope is ready for first light. Turn on the red dot viewfinder by rotating the large knob under the viewfinder lens clockwise. Look through the viewfinder and turn one or both of the viewfinder's alignment screws until the red dot is precisely over the same object as you centered in the eyepiece. When finished, turn off the viewfinder. To move the 60 and 70mm models, slightly loosen both of the star-shaped altitude control knobs. Loosening these knobs allows you to move the telescope up and down. Slightly loosen the horizontal lock knob. Loosening this lock allows the telescope to be moved from side to side. For the 80, 90, and 102mm, to move the telescope in the vertical direction, use the panhandle on the rear mount to make course adjustments. With an optional telescope carrying bag, these telescopes can be easily transported and are the perfect scopes for beginner astronomers going camping or in the backyard for stargazing and casual observing. Have a good time when you're observing. You may not know everything there is to know about a telescope or what all the sights in the universe are, but that's okay. Just point and observe at first. You will enjoy your telescope even more as you learn more about it. But don't be scared off by difficult terms or complicated procedures. Just relax and enjoy your new Infinity Telescope.